वेलकम टू इंग्लिश लिटरेचर क्लास माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 11th. हियर आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट स्टोरी, स्टोरी नंबर टू, रादर यू से चैप्टर नंबर टू, फ्रीड्स फ्रॉम इकोज, योर शॉर्ट स्टोरी बुक. फ्रीड्स, फ्रीड्स इज अ डॉल. फ्रीड्स a thriller story which feels you thrilling, a thriller by Satyajit Ray, a very renowned filmmaker as well as the author, writer. So you please listen the story Fritz in short, and after that I'll explain the chapter in detail in my next video. Here listen the story, pay your full attention. Here Jayanto plays a very important role, main role, you say, the protagonist. He is the protagonist in the story, main character. Who plays the main character is called protagonist. So Jayanto, the protagonist of the story, and his friend Shankar, the narrator of the story. The story Fritz is narrated by Jayanto's friend Shankar, were sitting in the garden of the circuit house in Bundi, in Rajasthan. It was on the instance of Jayanto, it was on the insistence, he insist Jayanto. He insist of Jayanto. It was on the insistence of Jayanto. Shankar was insisted that they had come to Bundi in Rajasthan and not to some well-known place like Jaipur, Udaipur or Chittor. Jayanto wanted to go to Bundi, not other important places in Rajasthan like Jaipur, Udaipur or Chittor. Actually, Jayanto had come to Bundi before as a child. Jayanto had come to Bundi before as a child when he was only 6 years old. When he was 6 years old, he was at Bundi. He had returned after 31 years. He had got the chance to go there after 31 years. After 31 years. The fort of Bundi was an attraction for both the visitors. Both mean Jayanto and Shankar. After some time, Shankar noticed that Jayanto had turned rather quiet. He seemed to be in low spirits, though they were at Bundi and enjoying themselves, seeing the sight of Bundi and fort. Though he denied it, both the friends went for a stroll in the garden after tea. Suddenly, Jayanto was reminded of a deodar tree which he had ought to be there somewhere. He said, ought to be there somewhere. When he saw it, he was in a jubilant mood. In happy mood. He says, yes, it is here, exactly where it was before. After this incident, his memories of the place began returning one by one quickly. He remembered that the name of their cook was Dilawar. When they were here, he could recall where his father used to sit or where his mother used to knit. Janto recalled everything about a unique doll his uncle had brought for him from Switzerland. It was a 12-inch long figure of an old man. It was very lifelike. His uncle told him that the man who sold him the doll told him that the old man was called Fritz and that he must call him by that name. He should be called Fritz. Jendo was so in a mood of Fritz that he played only with him. He was so much attached with him that he played only with him, though he had a variety of other beautiful toys. He began to spend hours just talking to the old man, even though he did not respond. His parents warned him against playing too much with the doll. While narrating his story about the doll, Jayanto paused for some time and then resumed his story. He told his friend how one day the doll was torn apart and ruined by a couple of stray dogs. The stray dogs ruined it. The doll's face was completely disfigured and was beyond recognition. Fritz stopped to exist for him anymore. The doll was then buried under that Devdar tree. Under the Devdar tree. Shankar now realized why Jayanto was serious to find out the Devdar tree in the garden of the circuit house. Both the friends, Jayanto and Shankar, went to bed at about 10. Shankar was the first to sleep. A slight noise woke him a little later. Slight noise. He saw that Jayanto was in some problem. Jayanto with anxiety on his face was sitting up on his bed. Jayanto told him that something had walked over his chest and that had woken him up. He added that actually that was the second time he had woken up and that the first time he heard a shuffling noise near the window. After having woken up, he switched the light on, but there was nothing to be seen. Shankar ruled out the possibility of a rat or a cat since both the doors were bolted from the inside. He said that there would be a cat or a rat, but there was no chance because the door was bolted inside. Jayanto said that whoever come in must be still in the room. At this, Shankar got up and searched everything to find anything, but in vain. That was futile. He was startled by the alarm in Jayanto's call. Jayanto showed him some tiny brown circular marks on the cover of his quilt. Shankar said that these could have been made by a cat. The sign. Circular marks. Could have been made by a cat. Jayanto keep quiet. He kept quiet. Shankar was sure that his friend had a bad dream, nightmare. He slept soundly. In the morning, he could see that Jayanto had not slept well. Jayanto could not sleep well, but Shankar slept soundly. They went to see the fort in a car. Jayanto's forgotten memories began coming again. After some time, he was quiet and morose. On the way back to the town, he startled his friend with his revelation. He said, "Fritz came into our room last night. Those little marks on my quilt were his footprints." Fritz came. Shankar could not help catching hold of him by the shoulders and shaking him. He thought how an adult person like him could be so obsessed with such an absurd idea. The door was bolted. Back at the circuit house, he decided to get his friends rid of his fanciful idea. He suggested digging the ground under the Devdar tree where Fritz was buried several years ago. He said that a gardener could be requested to dig the ground. At first, Jayanto did not accept the suggestion, but later he accepted it. The gardener was approached and requested for the digging of the ground under the Devdar tree. He got ready for the job after some reluctance. He was not willing. When the gardener started digging, Jayanto became very serious and continued to stare at the site. Even in the pleasant weather, the collar of his shirt was soaked in sweat. He was sweating. After some time, his eyes were bulging. He was pointing at the hole in the ground. His finger was visibly trembling. His voice was hoarse, horrible with fear when he said, "What? What is that?" Shankar gaped at the ground, and what was horrified scene was there. In the hole, lying flat on its back, was a 12-inch long, pure white, perfect little human skeleton. Perfect 12-inch long, perfect little human skeleton. That was the story, and you will study in detail in my next video. Thank you so much, students.